Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, and solid-state drive. Removal. Important. Make careful note of the routing of all cables connected to the system board for later replacement. Disconnect the power connector cable from its connector on the system board. Important. Make careful note of which cable is connected to each connector on the wireless module for later replacement. Carefully disconnect the wireless antenna cables from the wireless module by grasping the connectors with a small pair of needle-nose pliers or tweezers. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the webcam cable ZIF connector and disconnect the webcam cable from the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the display panel cable ZIF connector and disconnect the display panel cable from the system board. Disconnect the speaker cable from its connector on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the touchpad board ZIF connector and disconnect the touchpad board ribbon cable from the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the keyboard ZIF connector and disconnect the keyboard ribbon cable from the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the keyboard backlight ZIF connector and disconnect the keyboard backlight ribbon cable from the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the hard disk drive adapter ZIF connector and disconnect the hard disk drive adapter ribbon cable from the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the card reader board ZIF connector and disconnect the card reader board ribbon cable from the system board. Remove the two 4mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the fan and system board to the top cover. Remove the 8 3mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the top cover. Remove the 2mm P0 Phillips head screw that secures the wireless module to the top cover. Grasping the system board near the center, carefully lift the left edge of the system board off of the alignment pins and slide the external connectors out of the cutouts in the top cover. Remove the system board. Note, before installing a system board, remove the following from the old system board and install on the new system board. Memory boards. Heatsink. Wireless module. Reverse this procedure to install the system board. Important: after system board replacement, be sure to complete post-installation tasks as required that may include verifying functionality of the notebook, updating the BIOS, updating DMI and other settings.